I was raised in a world where excess was a dirty word. You know, this kind of extravagant, opulent color. I was raised in a world where tidy was better. You know, where everything has to be in its place, neat and arranged, and there's so much energy. If you're fortunate, down the road, something will snap. For me, it happened sitting on my back deck, looking out over the Puget Sound. The sun was setting, and the sky turned this effluence of slate blue and vermilion. It was like this batter pouring colors from a giant pitcher. And the tips of the trees, the cedars and the firs and the hemlock, were like backlit like giant puppets on an immense screen. And then I stood, for some unknown reason, and sang, "Jeremiah was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine," at the top of my lungs, and then did a boogie with my dog Conroy, who has no idea what's come over me, but he's a sucker for a party, so he joins in. And then I had to let the moment melt around me and catch my composure and give myself a quiz justifying what I had just done and why, and then I realized I couldn't tell a soul about my dance at twilight without coming face to face with who I was pretending not to be. And all of the energy it required to maintain that tidy image. I used to spend time at a Benedictine monastery, and I took a friend, and so he asked one of the monks, "So, what do you guys do?" The monk said, "We pray." My friend said, "No, really. I mean, what do you really do?" The monk said, "It is enough just to pray. It is enough, I tell my dog Conroy, just to boogie. Just to boogie under the inexplicable marbled canopy of dusk. Just to feel your lungs swell and your heart flutter. Just to cheer the sun as it sets. And not give a damn about the need to fight back the tears standing in the salty prism of twilight rainbows." Gardening is about the simplicity and extravagance and exuberance, and it's good for the soul.